What's up, guys? This is Alexander, obviously. Question that was asked about calisthenics. So calisthenics is the old school technical term for body weight training. The question was, what do I think of guys that only do calisthenics / body weight training, since they seem like they're really fit compared to guys that lift weights? This is one of those questions that, you know, like I always say, guys, context. I'm not really sure. If you are under the impression that just training with body weight is going to get you to, I guess, insane levels of physical fitness, you're probably kind of misguided. Not to say that body weight training isn't effective, but the people that use body weight training very effectively, they specialize in it, and they do so for years. It's not just a situation of where you start doing some push-ups and pull-ups and lunges and squats, and then, you know, within 3 months, you're shredded, you're cut, you got a Greek god body, you're transformed. The bodyweight athletes that I've seen on, you know, YouTube, bar stars, those guys, you know, there's a few things. One, they've been doing that for a while, a long time. Like I said, it's been years they've been practicing. Two, they have, you know, somewhat of a gymnastics type body in the first place, where they're well suited to get those kinds of results. So, you know, that plays a huge, huge role. Three, they also are genetically, you know, they're genetic high responders to that kind of training, where they get a surreal level of muscle growth from a form of training that would not yield that level of muscle growth for most people. So you have to take all that into account. Same thing with high level gymnasts. You know, much is made of gymnast bodies, and wow, look at this guy, and you know, the gymnasts are ripped, they got huge biceps, etc., etc. Gymnasts are genetically pre-selected from a young age. They train for years, you know, sometimes even decades, and they're all about 5'4". And the ones that weren't good at gymnastics have already dropped off. So when you watch the Olympics or shit like that every 4 years, and you're marveling at the guys' physiques, you're seeing the creme de la creme. That, you know, that's the absolute cream of the crop. You know, the tip of the spear. Those are the guys that were the absolute best at it. And I don't know if they are accurate, reasonable representations of the potential of body weight training for the average person. So, you know, body weight training as a training method, is it effective? Yes, absolutely. I've said this before many times. You need to be able to do body weight exercise. You need to have mastery over your own body within the fundamental movements. That's a given. That said, is body weight training by itself going to create the physique that you want? Maybe not. You know, like anything else, you're going to have to take a long-term approach for it, and you need to be reasonable about it. If you want to be, you know, let's just say fit, you're not really looking to maximize your muscular size at all. You want to, you know, train very often. Since body weight training, you have to do a lot of it for it to have an effect. Then yeah, sure, you can train with body weight. It's reasonable. You know, the only reason I don't endorse it wholly is because I don't consider it an optimal approach. You can get better results and faster results and more complete results by using body weight and free weights together. They're not mutually exclusive. I tell you guys this all the time. These are not mutually exclusive methods of training. It's not that you have to pick body weight or pick weights and then you do one or the other. You know, for guys that only train with weights, yeah, I have seen it obviously where guys, they lift weights, they never do anything with body weight, and they have certain incompetencies. I've also seen it guys that just train with body weight, they never lift weights, and then when they actually have to move anything that is weight, they're actually not that strong. You know, or at least not that physically adept as you would think they would be. But, you know, they can do a lot of, you know, chimps per se. So, well, that's impressive. I'm like, that's just one physical skill. If you want to be a completely developed human being, if you want to optimize your athletic functionality, you want to do everything. You want to be able to do everything. So it is something of a jack-of-all-trades approach in that regard. I would never advise someone to just pick one thing and then, you know, that's just the thing that you do. That's why I don't, you know, talk about only training with kettlebells or only training with a barbell or only training with dumbbells or only training, you know, with a suspension trainer or only training, you know, what I think of Indian clubs. Everything can work and everything can have an effect. All of it can. Everything. If you want to optimize the effects, then do all of it, learn how to use all of it, and then you can optimize your training, and then you'll have, you know, a body that you want. You'll have your dream body, or at least some level of physicality that you can be proud of. So calisthenics, does calisthenics factor into that? Yes, it does. Is it the complete picture? How should I phrase this? Yeah. Is it the complete picture as to what training is? No, it's not. So that's my answer for you for the guy that asked the question. At the same time, guys, you know, when you are watching shit on YouTube or, I don't know, fucking Snapchat or Instagram, keep in mind context. Watching a whole bunch of people that are the best in the world at something and then using those as representations of what you think your potential is, very fucking inaccurate. If I showed you pictures of, you know, elite level IFBB pro bodybuilders, you know, and then you get the impression that bodybuilding is going to make you look like those guys, no, it's not. You know, the same way that if you want to get into powerlifting, sure, but, you know, looking at what a 275-pound powerlifter does and how strong he is, the way he trains after being elite for 15 years might not be how you need to train or what you should be doing right now as a relative beginner novice. You do not, I've said this before, again, I say a lot of things over and over again, you do not want to use outliers and exceptions as guides and heuristics as to what you should be doing. Those people are certainly impressive, those people are certainly inspiring perhaps, but it doesn't mean that they're accurate examples of just copy them and then you're going to look like them or be like them or be able to perform like them. Not how this shit works at all. Any questions, guys? Any questions? Yes, no, maybe still, ladies and gentlemen. No, we're good. We're good. All right, guys. Talk to y'all again. Train everything. Use everything. Optimize yourself. Don't think in singularities. Adios.